Welcome back to Let's Play The Outer Worlds Peril on Gorgon DLC. I am Amethyst Lunatari. We're about to get to the end of this. Pretty sure, anyway, unless we have some surprises in store.
Quietly now.
Yep, going quietly now because we're going to fast travel to the Synthesis and Manufacturing Center? SMC building. Where the hell it is. Guessing it leads up here. And, there were marauders around here when we were last here, I'm pretty sure. And, we haven't been to that way for quite a while, so they've probably come back. That's why I wanted to sneak.
This can't be worse than anything we already seen, right?
I wonder what surprises they have in store for us here.
Well, these guys are no surprise.
Wake up with us!
Someone's butt. Oh, I thought I switched weapons.
Everyone all right?
It's fine, it's fine. So it'll be cool, now we can get in here. Because all these buildings we visited on the outside and then found out they were all sealed. I'm gonna go around unsealing them. And that was quite the thing. Saw these. One of them, at least. Just reload. Entrance status sealed. Unsealed door. Stop with the scary sounds. I don't appreciate it. Synthesis and Manufactory Center, right? Yeah, that's the name. Alright. Pam? Pam doesn't look unfriendly. Hope it stays that way. Are you a friend, Pam?
The Adrena Time Synthesis and Manufacturing Center.
Really?
Brought to you by Spacer's Choice. This productivity automechanical unit is at your disposal. Its normal duties involve the management of legacy operations analytics. However, due to the promotion, demotion, death, or injury to other managers of this facility, this unit is now the acting manager of the following departments: Reception, Human Resources, Accounting, Technical Support, Manufacturing, Distribution, Security. Please direct any questions about those departments to Pam. Answers not guaranteed.
Legacy Operations Analytics. Never heard of it.
According to this facility's records, the Legacy Operations Analytics department is located on sublevel floor 1. Its functions include warm bodies and redacted. Access to that department is currently denied, due to a lockdown in the sub-level stairwell.
Warm bodies. I just noticed the little nameplate. So it only existed to meet some minimum personnel requirement?
We value each and every member of the Spacer's Choice family, so be proud! On average, you contribute positively to a minimum of 1.44 important spreadsheets per quarter. That was one of Pam's patented pep talks designed to efficiently eliminate any negative feelings that are getting in the way of your work. After all, Pam's purpose is to answer one question. How can I increase your productivity today?
Huh. Well, that doesn't really apply to me. What's with all the bodies?
Did you know that keeping your workers alive boosts productivity? That's why every PAM unit comes equipped with the latest Spacer's Choice weaponry. When PAM's emergency combat protocols are activated, your investments are sure to be protected. Warning! Due to power consumption, combat protocols cannot be activated when PAM's power is below 73%. Without deactivating managerial processes. Spacer's Choice policy dictates that managerial processes take priority. This unit's power rating is 57%.
Huh. Well, if I engage the emergency combat protocols, you're just gonna attack me. How can I recharge you?
Hate messing with tangled cables or confusing batteries? With PAM, you'll never have to. Just pop in a Firefly brand industrial strength battery, and PAM's ready to go. Out of batteries and need productivity now? No problem. Just hook PAM's power source up to another automechanical, and PAM will get your employees back in line in no time.
Okay. I don't want you to go in combat, so...
How can I increase your productivity today?
Tell me about this facility.
The Adrenatime Synthesis and Manufactory Center is where Spacer's Choice's newest product is being created. Get a leg up on the competition with Adrenatime. You are now in the lobby. The floors above you are the offices, the manufactory, and the Adrenatime Synthesizer. The floors below you are the sublevels and the synthesizer reactor. How can I increase your productivity today?
Huh. Should we go down first and then up? So you're a productivity automechanical?
PAM helps each and every member of the Spacer's Choice family be the best they can be. When you're managed by PAM, your workday gets unjammed.
How do you keep people more productive?
Feeling down? PAM is loaded with over 1,000 encouraging messages, each designed to make you feel like an important member of the Spacer's Choice family. Schedule slipping? Not to worry. PAM tracks all of your deadlines and has the tools to whip your efficiency back into shape. You'll be a team player in no time, thanks to PAM.
So you're actually in charge of people?
Don't think of PAM as your boss. I'm just your pal. Here to make sure that every member of the Spacer's Choice family stays on task and on schedule. With PAM at the helm, you'll never be overwhelmed.
My pal.
How can I increase your productivity today?
PAM, I need a boost to my productivity. How about some motivation?
Reminder. Please do not reheat your salt tuna in the company kitchens. Save that savory smell for your own micro-apartments.
Do you have any additional things to say?
Remember, Spacer's Choice is a family, so overtime is really family time.
This is not motivating me at all.
Don't forget to add an exclamation point and a smiley face to your company messages. That's how we know you're having fun.
Okay, I should go. That one was funny. Okay, so if you get to 75%... Gotta be something else here. Above, I'm guessing. If you get to 75%, then you will attack people, possibly including me. I don't feel like fighting you if I don't have to, so Chose not to override or whatever what might be involved. So we've got something here and here. Then there's some offices on the other side. Looks like some kind of auditorium or meeting room here, maybe? Olivia's journal? Gotta be through a door and not sitting right there. Facilities office. There'd be baddies in here. I think. We're past all this. Ham unit energy cell. Why do I really want to use that? An industrial strength energy cell meant for Series 12C automechanicals manufactured by Firefly. Part of Firefly's premium grade line of products. Now 6.3% less likely to combust from overheating. Now that activated something in the journal. Optional enlist Pam's help. Oh, you've discovered an old productivity automechanical. It possesses a combat mode that might prove useful, but you'll need to fully charge its batteries or find an override code in order to activate it. You found a battery that can bring Pam to full power, but why won't Pam then attack me instead? Right? 8 cases, Bumblebee, Pale Kale Ale. Worston baked beans, woolly milk, spacious choice, tar mac and cheese. Alright, I hope I don't regret this. Alright. Please don't attack me.
Don't be shy. Pam units have an open door policy. We're always free to chit-chat. How can I increase your productivity today?
Pam, engage security combat protocols.
Emergency combat protocols cannot be engaged at less than 73% power without proper authorization. Please ensure that this unit is fully charged, or present your override password.
What you doing? Replace the battery.
This unit's power rating is 100%. Great! Emergency combat protocols are now available. Error. Employee's biometric ID does not match this unit's designated manager.
Oh.
Proceeding with verbal management test. Pretend that this PAM unit is one of your employees who has been working long hours. What would you say to give them an extra pep pill in their step?
Great. We just had a test to get into that secret hideout. Okay, you're one of the employees that were working long hours. What would you say to give them an extra pep pill in their step? No, I don't think we can forget about the test. I think then attack would begin. Lie about the promotion? That promotion is right around the corner. Keep putting in those hours.
Pam is equipped to talk about your career goals. On average, employees managed by Pam units go from assistant to associate roles in 15 years or less.
Is that good?
My door is always open, unless I'm recharging. Verbal management test complete. Result. Employee is a Spacer's Choice Manager.
Yeah.
94% certainty.
Sweet.
Engaging emergency combat protocols. Stand by.
You're gonna have to see this. You chasing down the baddies? Or you just patrol around here?
If I didn't know better, I'd swear it was watching me.
No, wait. That head's not spinning all the way around, is it? Well, that's not unsettling at all.
Nah. Looking for the baddies?
System alert, sweeping the area.
Feels great, doesn't it? I'm gonna run back and check out everything.
System beginning security patrol.
Guess we should have helped out. Can you get your butt out of my face? Damn. Okay. I'm out of tactical. There we go. Butts in the face! Butts in the face! More. Vending machine. Sorry you died, Pam. Guess I should have helped out a little bit. I really wanted to see the show. Quite an interesting show. Now we gotta run down and take care of everything else. Look at all the stuff we bypassed. Just trying to remember this room. We'll fully explore. And head back. Around the desk here? Is this a desk or a table? Right. Let's sell some stuff and then head back down. How do we get? Technical support. How did I get... How do we get up here? I guess through this door? Is that a way down? I wasn't paying attention to how we got up here. I thought we ran down this hallway. Did we go through all this? We did. This is where the first battle occurred. And then I guess we went these stairs? Everything... Yeah, we ran through here. But there should be nothing left in here. Well, no one left in here. What's that weird noise? Work our way down. Okay. Department Technical Support, current user M. Liu. Personal files. It's a dark screen. Retrieving personal files. Stand by. Files located. Tech support would like to remind all employees that this is not the messenger menu. Saving these files will not send a message to another Spacer's Choice employee, even if it is saved to a directory with the same name as said employee. Thank you. Displaying file directory. Automechanical repair power siphoning. A file name Pam. Power siphoning. Primary author M. Liu. With the battery shortage, I need to find a way to recharge Pam in a pinch. Vargas and I have to divide up all the remaining batteries, and eventually even those won't hold much of a charge. At least, not if you just plug the unit into the wall as displayed. Turns out, though, Spacer's Choice batteries actually only charge at half capacity if you use them as intended. I think it's planned obsolescence. They want the batteries to wear out sooner, so folks buy more of them. It doesn't make much sense to do it at your own facilities, in my opinion, but what the hell do I know, right? Anyway, I think I found a way to bypass it, at least on the biped models. If you take two similar units, link their power supplies, and initiate a surge from one unit to the other, it should force the battery to use its full capacity. Basically, I can double the lifespan of our batteries by having the units jumpstart each other. Not going to use it yet, just yet though. Always a chance that someone catches wind of it and they close the loophole, so I'd better save it for an emergency. Pam, weapons tuning. I cannot believe that they gave Pam a damn N-ray cannon. Talk about overkill. Hey, we're great. There's not much in the known galaxy deadlier than N-ray radiation, and once it's let loose, it's hard to contain. Most living things seem to give it off in microscopic doses, not enough to be harmful on its own, but enough to draw larger, deadlier masses of N-rays from one living thing to another within a certain radius, which means I need to take extra care to make sure Pam's cannon is tuned for maximum precision. If the barrel is even 1 degree out of alignment, you'd risk thousands of bits in collateral damage every time she fires it. Alright. Messages. To J. Vargas, subject, keep your head down. Last week, a pair of technicians at my designated workplace fell into a pretty bad row. There were a lot of seditious words used. I don't want to repeat them here. Management stepped in. I haven't seen them since. I don't think their indenturement contracts are nullified. Otherwise, I would have received a reprimand myself on account of having worked with terminated colleagues. How would you know they'd be terminated? They haven't been in their domiciles. They haven't been at their stations. I don't think they were fired. I think they deserted. I'm not going to share their names because I don't want that on my audit record. All I know is that the office isn't working the way it should. Dr. Ambrose is nervous, and when she's nervous, we're all nervous. From J. Vargas. Okay, this is from J. Vargas. V, keep your head down. Michael. Okay, so it's Michael, Lou. One of my colleagues disappeared 3 nights ago. She'd been falling behind her deadlines. Excuse me. And was medicating herself with adrenatine. I was jealous of her work ethic, so I can't imagine what compelled her to just disappear. Frankly, I'm glad. She was starting to make me look bad. There's something strange happening in the office, and I don't know what to make of it. Nothing's going according to plan. Clarence mostly had a phrase he muttered now and then. The Bancroft coefficient is approaching 1. Apparently there's some fellow named Lucian Bancroft. If he's real, Dr. Ambrose answers to him. I think he's a cipher or a code name or something. Maybe this is our mystery figure then. Lucian Bancroft. Which may or may not be his real name. I don't know how chaotic or messy a project has to be before that coefficient hits 1, but I know bad things happen when Lucian Bancroft shows up. Contracts nullified, waste disposed, assets eliminated. Yeah, I'll keep my head down. Judith. So it's a Judith Vargas. Cautious, because we have a lot of blips here on our radar. It was awesome seeing Pam go while it lasted, wasn't it? I like that. Really starting to think she was invulnerable after a while, but alas, 'twas not the case. Another monitor. Current user J. Vargas. Julia, right? Messages. To A. Isaac, subject re inappropriate automech. Sir, I promise you, no automechanical in the galaxy is capable of falling in love with you. It is far outside their set of capabilities. If there is a legitimate reason that this current automechanical is not fulfilling your department's needs, please file a request for an upgrade using Form AM265B with permission from your manager. Thank you. Judith Vargas. That's to A. Isaacs, okay. To A. Isaacs, subject apologies. No, sir, that was not a comment about your inability to secure a marriage contract. No automechanical is capable of loving you because they are literally not capable of loving anyone. Makes sense? Automechanicals function through a simple series of state machines that are designed to problem-solve for a limited list of scenarios. These scenarios all directly relate to the task that the automechanicals was created for. In other words, a security automechanical might be able to question unauthorized personnel about where they left their biometric ID card, but a chef automechanical can only ask them if they want extra salt. Even if, in theory, an automechanical was deliberately modified to learn speech patterns and how to mimic human behavior, those behaviors would be a hollow imitation. So if your automechanical assistant really did make a comment about your posterior, it was because they were programmed to say it. That's all. Really. From Michael Liu, subject, don't transfer. Judith, now is not the best time to request a transfer. I've got a reliable source that tells me that the OCI may be under official audit soon. There's been a word of some kind of corporate sabotage. I wouldn't request a transfer to the Chem Labs either. They've just had their budget and their personnel slashed. Trust me, you don't want to be associated with either office. Stay with us. We know what we're doing. And all these people are dead, right? Oh my god, there's so many message terminals. Main menu. Technical support. Current user S. Tinsley. Okay, messages. To V. Newell. Any relation to Gabe? I think it's spelled differently, isn't it? Subject. Re. Out of. I thought it was going to be out of stock. It says out of sock? Mr. Newell, no, there were no socks involved in the production of Spacer's Choice Terrified Spratwurst. The T hologram on the machine is likely just manufacturing. A malfunctioning. It should read out of stock. Best Sam Tinsley technical support. To T. Sutherland, subject re-return button. Miss Sutherland, I regret to inform you that vending machines do not take returns. Please try to fit your can of Spacer's Choice. Please do not try to fit your can of Spacer's Choice gourmet salt tuna fillets into the bit cartridge slot, as it will damage the machine and prevent other employees from using it. Thank you so, so much for your time. So much. That was funny. Oh my.
Nice.
Thanks. Okay. T. Jaramillo. To H. Putnam, subject a note on notes. Harold, prosperous morning. This is an informal reminder that your adhesive notes are intended to track your trouble tickets. Please do not use your adhesive notes to create patterns on your divider wall. I'd hate to remind you that unsanctioned aesthetic expression is strictly contrary to Spacer's Choice law, and I definitely hate to be reprimanded because I didn't warn you. Please endeavor to use adhesive notes in a manner prescribed by the Spacer's Choice official guidelines. Sincerely, Tony Jaramillo. Not used to create patterns on your divider wall. To Michael Liu, subject friendly language for a friendly office. Michael, this is just to tell you that I've reported your recent unsanctioned language to human resources. What a guy. You were recently talking about seeing some of your colleagues act paranoid and violent. Try to remember the new guidelines from corporate. Don't call your colleagues paranoid. They're experiencing dramatically heightened attention. Don't call your colleagues violent. They're showing physically assertive behavior. Oh, God. I'm as concerned as you are about the curious and surprising behavior we've been seeing around the premises, but try to keep your language sanitized. Clean language is a matter of security. It's a matter of bull, is what it is. Any more terminals? Oh, hi. All of a sudden, you're there. Wouldn't want to miss the terminal. We can't access that, and that we've seen. No, no. Can't access those. What about here? Can't go here. We can go here, but we can't read anything. Same here. I wonder what that noise is. Oh, here's the ash piles. Somehow pulling stuff out of there. Oh, there's someone right there! How'd these guys get in here? I thought she took care of all of them.
What a fight on our hands!
Look at us.
I think the rest are outside this room. Someone on the move. But they must be in that room up beyond. I didn't think there was anyone left in here. All this time we're walking around with two marauders in here. This guy was trying to loot this thing. He can't pick this lock.
That hands cap.
Okay. We've looted this entire room. Now all the ones that Pam went through, the doors have closed themselves. So, yeah, this is the only way through. I guess we'll go down here. I think that's the way we went. Then we'll go back up. Might as well get rid of this stuff while we're here. I don't think I picked anything up. Oh, I did pick up this. That's right, I picked that up. Safe. I see you.